Meet prisoner 2479. What do these people have in common with prisoner 2479? We see a disabled person, an elderly, and a professional. They are all behind bars. We are all behind bars. Some of them are literal, and some are figurative. We have different problems, health issues, it can be. If you are elderly, you can be lonely. If you are disabled, if you are a professional, you can get stuck in the rat race. Maybe marital problems. And you can feel excluded from society. And I believe that everyone should be able to take part in society. And I'm fascinated by a group of people who are the most extreme examples of exclusion. I work with a group of inmates who are called the Top 600 in Amsterdam. And this group consists of men who were found guilty of high-impact crimes in Amsterdam. And it's my job to work with them inside and outside of prison. I am part of the reintegration team to help these men function again when they are released. And the reintegration process starts in the prison. And there are other programs for the practical aspect. I focus, and my team, on the personal development. Because research has shown that fewer criminals fall back into their old behavior when investing in the development of their soft skills, like empathy, identity, trust, motivation. So my job is to work with the top 600 inmates who are the heavy criminals from this place, Amsterdam, but also they are excluded from society. And it's my belief that when you seriously harm another person, that you lose or have lost touch with your humanity. And the way to get back in touch with your humanity is by having real meaningful contact with humans, real people. That's why I designed a program. Because they say the sense of a human being, the basic sense of a human being is the sense of belonging. It's important that you feel that you belong. And you see here a picture from a program that I designed. And you see different people from excluded groups who are sitting and having dinner together. So the elderly, the disabled, and also ex-convicts. And the dinner is fantastic, delicious, and it's prepared by the ex-convict. And you will be surprised what happened. For example, this elderly woman, she was reprimanding, "Hey, look at me when you're talking to me." And he didn't get mad, because she is older. And this disabled man, he needs help when he goes to the restroom. So I asked one ex-convict to help him. And he was like, "No, I can't." And I was like, "Yes, you can." And he came back with a glow on his face, full of confidence. And this is a part of the program. We also do theater together, put on plays, because I believe that You have to learn to deal with frustration. And if you have, if they are preparing or practicing for a play, then sometimes somebody say a line wrong. And instead of hit him, you must have some self-control. So they learn to have self-control. And they learn to connect. And they learn to open up to other people's opinion. And I saw how people really connected with each other, really see each other. And it was a natural process in a safe environment. They kept each other sharp and focused. You saw how people, yeah, they opened up, felt like they belong. And we also do small, intimate sessions, group sessions in prison. And during one session in prison, 5 men were asked to write about a significant experience in their life and what effect this has had on them. And next to me was Chris. And he asked me how to write crying. So I wrote it for him. And then he asked me how to write screaming, because he was practically illiterate. It was his turn to tell his story. 6-year-old Chris was playing outside his grandmother's house in Colombia. He got called to come inside. He sees his whole family huddled together in the living room of his grandmother. He squirms in amongst them and feels a tension in the room. All of a sudden, a man dressed in black with a mask on entered the room and started screaming, "You haven't paid, so you will be punished for this." 3 other men, the same, dressed the same, entered the room and forced the uncle to come in front of the group. And the first man shoots him in the head. He dies on the spot, and everyone starts crying and screaming at the same time. And the other guys start threatening the crying family, "You better shut up or more will die." This is what happened if you didn't pay protection money to the drug cartels in Colombia. So I told Chris how sorry I am. And I asked him, "How has this affected your life?" He said, "He hasn't shed a tear since then." And he also said that he was 13 years old when he killed for the first time. How can you teach somebody and really reach somebody who is so damaged? And maybe we are all sitting here and we are not so damaged, but we have our own limitations. Youth traumas, marital problems, financial problems, health issues. It could be anything. But how can we look through these bars? And I believe, and that's why there is a lot of hope, that we are all like diamonds. And you know what's so special about a diamond? Wait a minute, I have bring one. And if I'm in prison, I say, "It's not a real one." And they say, "No, because otherwise your hand was off." Okay, a diamond. And what is so special of a diamond? Only another diamond can sharpen a diamond. So, and the more you sharpen the diamond, the more facets will come to reflect the light. And a special light your unique individual light. Because there's only one of us on this world. And when you are able to really make a connection with another person, really see them and be seen, then you break through bars. And that is a true prison break. It happens with these people. They have break through their own bars by make a real connection with each other. And you know what is so special? That life sometimes surprises you. Surprises you in an unexpected way. And it happened to me. I received a postcard, and I want to read it for you. Hi, sister. I often look at our photo and think about what you told me and all the things you taught me. I pray every day for a better life. You have taught me a lot in a short time. You have got a lot of talent. You will be all right. I work on it, and then I'm also where I have to be. Thank you for everything. Chris. And I can tell you, Chris is exactly where he needs to be. Because he has a partner, two beautiful children, and he works as a professional personal trainer. And Chris is just one example. And I'm grateful to do this work because it's rewarding. And we do this work in different prisons, and it works there. If it works in the prison, it can work everywhere. And it's our responsibility as a society that we involve everyone. No individual groups may be excluded because we are all, we have all the values that we need. And Chris is an example. He was a member of an excluded group. But he rediscovered his humanity by looking beyond his own bars. And now, how can you make a difference in somebody else's life? Yes, I'm talking to you. And you, because you have the possibility, the responsibility, and the power to create inclusion. But it starts by breaking through your own bars. Are you ready for your own prison break? Thank you.